Our entrance in,
God is so good.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. God cares for me. God cares for me.
This Mass, we shall be praying for all your personal intentions. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us first acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who have sent the power of the gospel like leaven into the world, grant that your faithful, whom you have called to live amid the world and its affairs, may be fervent with a Christian spirit, and through the tasks they carry out in this present age, may constantly build up your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Grow strong in the Lord with the strength of his power. Put God's armor on so as to be able to resist the devil's tactics. For it is not against human enemies that we have to struggle, but against the sovereignties and the power who originate the darkness of this world, the spiritual army of evil in the heavens. That is why you must rely on God's armor, or you will not be able to put up any resistance when the worst happens, or have any resources to hold your ground. So stand your ground with truth buckled round your waist and integrity for a breastplate, wearing shoes on your feet, the eagerness to spread the gospel of peace, and always carrying the shield of faith so that you can use it to put out the burning arrows of the evil one. And then you must accept the salvation from God to be your helmet and receive the word of God from the Spirit to use as a sword. Pray all the time, asking for what you need, praying in the Spirit on every possible occasion. Never get tired of staying awake to pray for all the saints, and pray for me to to be given an opportunity to open my mouth and speak without fear and give out the mystery of the gospel of which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I proclaim it and I may speak boldly as I ought to. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to God's word is, Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Together.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my arms for battle, who prepares my hands for war. Response.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
He is my love, my fortress. He is my stronghold, my savior. My shield, my place of refuge. He brings people under my rule. Response.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
To you, O God, will I sing a new song. I will play on the 10-string lute. To you who give kings their victory, who set David your servant free. Response.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Lord Jerusalem. He sends out his word to the earth.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Some Pharisees came up to Jesus. Go away, they said. Leave this place, because Herod means to kill you. And he replied, You may go and give that fox this message. Learn that today and tomorrow I cast out devils, and on the third day attain my end. But for today and tomorrow and the next day I must go out, since it would not be right for a prophet to die outside Jerusalem. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, you that kill the prophets and stone those who are sent to you. How often have I longed to gather your children as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you refused. So be it. Your house will be left to you. Yes, I promise you, you shall not see me till the time comes when you say, Blessings on him who comes in the name of the Lord. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, if we can sum up today's Gospel in one word, it is all about being bold. And this is what Jesus sets an example for everyone. Here was the same Herod who had already executed John the Baptist, and now the same Herod becomes a threat to Jesus. But Jesus was unafraid. He had a mission, and that mission had to be accomplished no matter what the opposition or what the threat to it was. Jesus was absolutely focused. This is what the Father has sent me to do, and nothing or no one can ever become an obstacle to the work that has been entrusted to me. This is the same kind of fervor, my dear brothers and sisters, that Paul had, that he speaks about in his letter to the Ephesians that we just heard. When he told us, pray to be given an opportunity to open my mouth and speak without fear, and give out the mystery of the gospel of which I am an ambassador in chains. So even if I am imprisoned, I have to continue to proclaim the gospel. Proclaim it boldly, without fear of anyone or anything. And he goes on to say in the first reading, pray that in proclaiming it, I may speak as boldly as I ought to. There is no reason, my dear brothers and sisters, for us to be afraid. Did Jesus not tell us just before he returned back to his Father, I will be with you always until the end of time? An assurance that he accompanies us on life's journey. Did he not also tell us, I will give you a helpmate who will tell you what and how to speak? The Holy Spirit empowers us, especially in the midst of persecutions and trials. We can see this happening around us today, an arrest of a Jesuit priest, and yet, my dear brothers and sisters, the gospel has to be spoken boldly. It has to be lived by us who proclaim Jesus as our Savior and as the Messiah of the world. May nothing or no one ever deter us. Like Jesus, may we too have the courage and be bold enough to proclaim Jesus and the gospel.
Our offertory hymn at this time of giving.
At this time of giving, gladly now we pray. Gifts that have been given by our God and King. Here is the bread of pain, work of human hands. This is the bread of joy we will share. This time of giving, gladly now we bring gifts that have been given by our Lord and King. See, Lord, this joy is mine, harvested from earth. This is a wine of love, ready for.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
O God, who will to save the whole world by the sacrifice of your Son, grant through the power of this oblation that your servants living in the lay state, whom you do not cease to call to the apostolate, may imbue the world with the Spirit of Christ, and be the leaven of its sanctification through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
An act of spiritual communion.
O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
A communion hymn, Late, Late Have I Loved You.
Let us pray. As we draw upon the fullness of your grace, we pray, O Lord, that your faithful, who by your will are engaged in the things of this world, may be strengthened by the power of the Eucharistic banquet to be tireless witnesses to the truth of the gospel, and may ever make your church present and active amid the affairs of this age, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found.
We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the peace and blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I assist in him, you who dwell.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadows for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Is that